Recently, obviously, we saw on Twitter just that you were basically, you know, we were all shocked and appalled. And you guys, I mean, I'm definitely, motherfuckers in Los Angeles, definitely insulted by what Kodak Black said on Instagram Live and how he's been behaving and shit. And you guys basically at Power 106 said you're not going to play any of his music. Sour Milk, you even deleted all his songs from your laptop, you know what I mean? And I was wondering, I was wondering, has that ever happened in radio where you guys banned somebody like that? And, you know, how long does this ban go for? And, I mean, I don't want to get too dramatic on how you guys were feeling about that, but, you know, like, I want to talk about the ban of Kodak Black or what's that signifying right now, you know?
Yeah. I think something like this is just kind of based on the situation, and we're all very close to this situation, and you know, it's a community, not just out here, but in our culture. You know, a DJ community, a music community,
right?
We're responsible for the energy that we put out through the airwaves. And I think it really started with just some super human shit. Like, yo, I can't see myself playing this song on Monday, you know, and Milk kind of bounced that same thing right back to me. And we kind of ran it up the flagpole, and credit to, you know, the Power B, at the radio station for, you know, having a similar vision and feeling on it. You know, it's just about being held accountable. You know what I mean? As we come on y'all show, we represent, you know, the LA Leakers. We represent Power 106. We represent scam artists. And, you know, we watch, you know, we're respectful of things that we say. And, you know, I said something on Instagram and the radio last night where I said, you know, support and respect kind of go hand in hand, you know. And if you don't respect us and the family and loved ones, then, you know, we just can't support your music. It's not really super personal. It's just like, yo, like, you know, I said, like, if I was to say something, you know, kind of reckless about one of our community members, you know, specifically Kodak Black, he's probably not going to call me to DJ his release party. It's just that simple. You know what I mean? Right, like, right. And we feel like the radio station has the responsibility to literally the Los Angeles community, and then culturally the whole hip hop community. So we were proud to take a stance and hold our community up with some integrity, and that was very poor judgment on his behalf. That's how I feel about it.
I don't really know, I guess, if there's a length of time that the ban will last or whatever. Like, you know, like we were saying, though, it's just, it's been a fucked up week. Right. So to see something like that, man, it just kind of, I don't know, man. It's just like super, super disrespectful, man.
Yeah, completely inappropriate. Definitely like unaware. Like there's no self-awareness there. You know what I mean? Just completely, it's just not, it was just really like, like you said, just really disrespectful.
And the other side of it too, you know, it started to shift the narrative and go into like this clown internet shit where even rappers were like getting online and commenting on it. You know, that's why, you know, the first draft of the tweet that I put up didn't go up. You know what I mean? Because we didn't want it to be like silly or joking. We wanted to keep it serious and swing it back. You know, Milk had just said like all of the immediate things that started to happen in a positive light and directions that we're trying to go. Mm-hmm. And that type of behavior puts all of us so far back. Right. You know what I'm saying? So we just wanted to take a stance and hold our ground and take a step in the right direction, you know? And there's a lot of people that don't agree with many things that certain artists do or certain, you know, celebrities do. And this is a step in the right direction of holding some integrity to it. We're not the radio police, you know what I mean? But you know, when we can, we want to put our necks out on the line and say, yo, this wasn't right.
Yeah. I mean, I totally agree with you, man. I totally agree with you. And what do you think it would take to lift the ban? What do you think would make some kind of amends for Kodak Black? What would he have to do? Or what do you think would show some type of, like, sincerity from him? You know what I mean? Is that even possible at this point? Or is it just only time will tell, right? I mean...
I want to say only time will tell, but honestly, like, I can't see him being able to fix that, in my opinion.
I mean, his apology was horrific. It was like the worst apology I've ever seen in my fucking life. You know what I mean? So
that's what I was gonna say. Is like, he had his chance. Even if the apology would have been good, I just don't know, man. I don't know if you could fix that. It's like that shit was so disrespectful, man. Like. I don't know, man. It's like, yo, LA is not even done mourning yet.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? Like we're still like, LA is still fucked up right now, man. And like, you got the nerve to fucking go on social media and like start saying all that reckless shit. Like, for what? I don't know, man. I just can't see. Personally, I can't see it being fixed. And if it doesn't, I don't give a fuck. You know what I'm saying? Like, I honestly, like, never had an issue with Kodak. I met Kodak, you know what I'm saying? But like, so to see him do some shit like that, you know what I'm saying? I know that's his thing, you know what I'm saying? Like, he just be talking reckless on it. Like, that's nothing new. But this, I feel like, was different. It's just, I don't know, man. I don't know if it's just because it's so close to home, you know?
Yeah,
but it was different, man. So for me, like, I'm cool on it. Like, I'm okay never playing a Kodak record again.